In this section, I'd like to cover some DPA administration, specifically adding an Avamar server using the data collection wizard. So the use case is obviously adding an Avamar server or an AVE to the DPA UI using the discovery wizard, which in turn will automatically assign and configure the agent requests for data collection from Avamar. Right, the agent requests dictate the type of data and how often it should collect. Now, before you begin, you will need an Avamar username password that has access to the MCDB. That's Avamar's MCDB. You may need to include the DPA agent host's IP address to the Avamar service firewall. You may also need to alter Avamar's pg_hba.conf file to allow the DPA agent to remotely connect to the MCDB. You may also need to reload the MCDB, it's like a restart, but you do not have to reboot the Avamar server itself. Okay, so there's no downtime. You can install a DPA agent on the Avamar server itself, for example, the utility node, or on the AVE, but you will need RPQ approval to do that. So let's jump right in. So the first thing to do is create your Avamar credential, right? I've already created it here. So I've created an Avamar credential standard. I created a username called DPA that can access the MCDB in read-only mode. It only requires read-only, does not require administrative privileges either. Then we go to the discovery wizard. I'm adding a backup application called EMC Avamar. We'll add one object. That's the IP address. It is a Linux OS. The next one is host system monitoring. So you only need to check this box if you want the DPA agent to collect host operating system statistics like CPU, memory, performance, configuration, file systems, etc. However, if you're collecting the data remotely, this will not be possible on a Linux OS. So this will only work if you've actually installed an agent on the Avamar server itself. If you don't have one, just leave it blank. Then which agent should be collecting the data? So if you have installed an agent on the Avamar server or AVE, you would select the top one. If you're collecting the data remotely, which is most of the cases, then you select which DPA agent you want to use to do the actual data collection. With that done, you click next. Then you obviously have to select the credential that you want to use, which is the one that I've just created. And then you come to the section that you do the test. You click on start test, and there you go. Give it a couple of minutes to execute the tests. There we go, test successful. You hit next. Where in the scope do you want to place it? If you want to add or modify any attributes, and finish, right? So now if you go into group library, for example, object library, should I say, you go to applications, there you'll see your Avamar server being added. If you click on data collection, you'll see the requests that have been assigned. The data has been collected remotely by the agent on this host, and this is the credential that it's using, the frequency that it's going to collect the data. And if you highlight any one of these, you can click on the history button to see the status of the request and when it ran last. If you highlight that, you'll get even more information at the bottom. And you can do the same with job monitor to check that at least it was successful and status, right? In DPA, we always generically collect configuration, job monitor, status, and possibly performance and any other requests that might be specific to that object, right? So we can do one further thing here with the job monitor. So when you install the DPA agent and you do the data collection wizard definition, the agent collects the data from now onwards. Okay, so if the Avamar server has been around for a while, or it was installed before DPA, there's obviously some possible job data in its history, right? So we can't go back to get previous configuration or statuses, but we can try and get historical jobs. So in order to do this, you hit the ellipse and say gather historical data, right? And where you can specify a start and end date. Now you have to be careful with this because you don't want to be too ambitious and collect a year's worth of data, right? Especially if the Avamar has a lot of history. If the Avamar server has a lot of history, I would recommend doing it in small chunks, a week at a time, perhaps a month at a time. This is a pure lab system with very little data in it, so I will be a little bit ambitious and set it back to the 1st of January, for example, right? There's very little in data in this, the history of the MCDB of this Avamar server, so I can afford to do that. If you're running it on a production system, do it in small chunks, okay? And there we go. Now, if I hit the history button, you'll see this highlighted line here where it says success. In other words, it has successfully submitted the request to gather historical data, but it hasn't actually finished yet. And what gives it away is this size parameter. The data has not come back yet from that request. So if I hit the refresh button, there we go. That's the amount of data that came back from the historical data collect. Now, if you want to check that, we can go into our reports, run reports, select our Avamar server, and I can do something like capacity planning. Right, under the capacity planning reports, I can have a look at the number of backup jobs per day, and let's look over the last month. Run report. Okay, so you can see I actually have job data in DPA plus its historical data. And this seemingly started around about the 19th of April. Okay. Similarly, with other just standard reports, you could also have a look at perhaps the amount of data backed up daily over the last month. Run the report. Okay. This is a lab system, so there's very little data being backed up. All right. Thank you. That's as simple as it is.